Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullah. Brothers and sisters, today I received some sad news about people who had visited Makkah al-Mukarramah from the UK and they had fulfilled their Umrah and they were on their way to Medina Munawwara and somehow there was a motor vehicle accident and some of them lost their lives. Inna lillahi wa inna ilayhi raji'un. Indeed, when we hear sad news, we say we all belong to Allah and every one of us is going to return to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So that was some really sad news that we heard. But that having been said, we need to understand that the Almighty chooses for us the way we will die. We always need to ask the Almighty to grant us a good death, and we always need to ask Him to grant us a death in a condition that He is pleased with us. Because sometimes we become so busy in our lives that we don't realize how close that death is for us, and we would not like to be caught on the wrong side. So we need to be conscious of death. The Prophet ﷺ used to say, whenever you pray, you need to make sure that you pray as though it's the last opportunity you're going to have to fulfill that prayer. Salli salata muwadda'in, which means fulfill your prayer as though it's a farewell prayer. Now, I want to ask everyone, including myself, when we pray, do we even pray on time? That's the thing. Number two is, when we do pray, do we make it rushed or do we take our time? And then we need to ask ourselves, are we really considering it the last prayer, the last opportunity perhaps that we would have to pray or to fulfill that salah? And I think we all need to become more conscious of it, including myself, because yes, even if we do fulfill the salah, but we can do much more to try and improve the quality of it. Now, one of the reasons why he said this was because one day it will definitely be true where it would have been the last prayer. We wouldn't like it to be one that was rushed, one that had no concentration and so on. We'd like it to be one that is absolutely perfect. That was, when I say perfect, I mean the best we could have done. Now, going back to those who've passed on between Mecca and Medina, may Allah give them Jannatul Firdaus. May Allah make it easy for their families. When we hear of a death, we say a dua for the deceased, for those who are left behind, for ourselves as well. May Allah make it easy for us the day He takes us away. May He make it easy for them in their graves. May He give them Jannatul Firdaus. Now, what's important for us to note is they had a blessed death. A blessed death in the sense that they had just fulfilled their Umrah, and we'd like to hope that the Almighty would forgive their sins. We'd like to hope that the Almighty would actually forgive them in a way that would be... Sorry, the phone is ringing, but it will be answered, inshallah. We'd like to hope that the Almighty will forgive them because of the good deed that they had actually done. So the good deed that they did, we ask the Almighty for that deed to be accepted and for them to be granted Jannatul Firdaus by the will of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Now, that is a consolation for those who have been left behind, because sometimes you have family members who are young, you know, it happens suddenly. I'm sure when people go on a trip overseas, they would not expect that these people are not going to come back. And they would not expect that we're going to die. Well, who expects to die anyway? But then it happens. And when it happens, it's a test from the Almighty. We need to say, Inna lillahi wa inna ilayhi raji'un. We all belong to Allah and we are all going to return to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So they had a blessed death. How many of us actually would pray that we also have a blessed death? My brothers and sisters, when a death happens, we have to surrender to the decree of Allah. We cannot question the Almighty. People say, you know, there are so many young people dying, there are so many babies that die, there are so many people who are innocent, who are suffering, struggling. It's the decree of the Almighty. It's part of the test. The Almighty did not say that you're going to have an easy time on earth, number one. Number two is, when you're taken away, you are actually going to a better place, the best possible place. I mean, those who were, who passed away in this particular way, perhaps Allah might grant them a status of a martyr and a very high status because they died while obeying Allah, while fulfilling the blessed journey and so on. So we ask Allah to grant the same to us, you know, a very high rank. Imagine you get to the other side and you are in such a beautiful place and the people people you left behind are so depressed and they're questioning Allah. Oh Allah, why did you do it? And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, you know, if we heard and if we could see, we would have actually said, subhanallah, it is such a beautiful place you guys are in. You know, I can't wait to get there either. So remember, when people die, when things are happening across the globe, yes, we are taught to defend ourselves, to protect life. We are taught to actually do as much as we can to ensure that people are comfortable, people are not struggling and suffering. And remember, what you do and what I do might be different because your capacity, my capacity could be very different. And what you think I should do and what I think you should do may not be applicable because it's not your life or mine. So I need to choose what I believe I can do, and you need to choose what you believe you can do, for as long as every one of us is doing something. And this is why I actually get quite irritated by people who say, what are you doing? What are you doing about these people and those people? What do you know what I am doing? And I don't need to know what you're doing, but I trust you enough to be at least making a dua and at least reaching out to them in whatever way possible. Like we've spoken about in the past, people are on different levels. And what is expected of you is one thing, what you can do is another. And what you are doing is a third. So let's try and make sure that we actually fulfill this responsibility upon us in the best possible way. But at the end of the day, we may not succeed completely to do what we would like to in terms of goodness. And you have people who lose their lives, you have people who struggle and suffer, people who've lost their homes, people who actually risk their lives in order to get to safety. This is very, very sad. But what can we do? At times, people question the Almighty. Don't question the Almighty. He knows what He's doing. He will elevate the status of those who bear patience. So keep bearing patience and keep trying. Don't give up. Don't give up until the point that you actually meet with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. When you meet with Allah, we now have hope in the mercy of, oh Allah, you sent me onto the earth. I tried my best. And I actually tried to fulfill everything that you asked me to. I struggled, I suffered, and you know, at the end of the day, you took my life away. Here I am with you. Do you really think at that point the Almighty is going to discard any one of us? No, He won't. By His will and His mercy, He will actually have His blessings upon us. He will actually grant us the best of the hereafter. This is why those who've lost loved ones, pray that the Almighty bless them with Jannah. I promise you, they are probably in a better place than you can imagine. And here we are losing our faith by questioning Allah, why did you take them away? And Allah says, hang on, but I'm giving them a better place than you're in. And I've actually taken them to my mercy. This is why when someone passes away, we say, intaqala ila rahmatillah. They have passed on into the mercy of Allah. So now that they've passed on into the mercy of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, we actually know that Allah is all merciful, all kind. He's not going to abuse, maltreat them, etc., or cause them to suffer again. But we need to work towards earning the pleasure of the Almighty. So don't forget your prayer. Don't forget the quality of your prayer. And don't forget the fact that any one of us can actually die at any time. We're going to be leaving behind people and loved ones. We're going to be leaving behind family members, perhaps children, perhaps spouses, perhaps whatever else. You know, parents at times, broader family, friends, business deals that were not finished, not complete. We owe, someone else owes, etc., etc. So much. It has happened. It is happening. It will happen. But remember, things will continue. I remember, you know, we were talking with a group of friends about how long you'd like to live. And the reality is, it's in the hands of Allah, but everyone is allowed to hope and to pray. Oh Allah, grant me life enough that I can see my children married, okay? That's what people say. And then they say, after that they say, oh Allah, grant me life enough that I can see my grandchildren. Okay, fine. Now you've seen your grandchildren. Then you say, oh Allah, grant me life enough that I can see my great-grandchildren. Then you say, oh Allah, make me from among those who can see my great-great-grandchildren. Where is it going to stop? So Allah says, hang on, we don't leave it to you, we take you away. When we know it's correct. So the correct dua is, oh Allah, when you're pleased with me, take me away. When you take me away, grant my family members ease. Let the people actually see the goodness, and let the people actually pray for me, and let them take care of whoever I've left behind from among the weak and downtrodden. Sometimes it happens. And this is why the hadith speaks and the Quran speaks about the treatment of orphans, the treatment of widows, the treatment of those who are underprivileged, the treatment of those who are vulnerable. And here comes the issue of abuse. Those who abuse orphans, those who abuse widows, those who abuse the vulnerable, those who abuse their own children, we've spoken about it, those who abuse their spouses, their family members, warnings have been issued by Allah for you. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala protect us all. We should be from among those who prepare for the hereafter by looking after those who are vulnerable. And this is why there's a great reward. If Allah wanted, He did not need you and I to actually take care of these people, but He wanted to give us rewards. He wanted us to have the opportunity to get closeness to him. And that's the reason why he decided and he chose that I will keep the fulfillment of the needs of those people by me through X, Y, and Z who are going to go there and reach out to them and so on. So my brothers and sisters, I really pray once again for those who lost their lives in that journey. It's not just them. There are so many others who lose their lives on a daily basis from so many different countries. I know of a lot of instances. People send me emails, please pray for this, pray for that. I ask Allah to grant me goodness to begin with. And then everyone else. There are so many people out there who are suffering, struggling. Don't question the Almighty and understand He is the most merciful. If there are little children struggling and suffering, the Almighty is their Lord. We will reach out to them. It's our test. Let's not be selfish. Let's not just look at it and say, oh Allah, help them. But reach out into your pockets. Try and assist them in one way or another. And if not, by the will of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, even if He chooses to take them away, perhaps that for them might have been a greater mercy than to be in the hands of merciless people who don't even care for them. And sometimes, brothers and sisters, in our own homes, we are absolutely merciless. And I've come across this and I repeat it because every single day, including today, I receive emails and messages about how abusive people are within their own homes and within their own circles and with those whom they live with. How cunning, how sly, how deceptive, how arrogant, how abusive, how violent people are in their own homes. And that's why the Prophet ﷺ says the best of you are those who are best within their own homes to their ahl, their family members, their spouses, their children, their brothers and sisters, their parents, etc. And the circle broadens. So you want paradise, you want a good death, you need to make sure you fulfill the rights of kinship and the relationships that Allah has placed for you. Allah chose for you who your relatives are, Allah chose for you your parents and everybody else. You need to make sure that you fulfill these relations because this is how you will be able to have barakah, blessings in your life. You know, you extend your life in one way or another as per the hadith of the Prophet ﷺ, and you have a good death. You know, whoever would like a good death should actually live in a good way. Because the hadith says you die the way you lived and you will be resurrected the way you died. So we ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to have mercy on us. I know from amongst us here there may be those who've lost loved ones not so long ago. Those who might have suffered losses, great losses. I read about what's happening in several countries where there is looting, there is fighting, there is killing, there are bombings, there are so many other things. There are fires that have, you know, affected people and their property was eaten up by the fire. May Allah make it easy for you. Trust me, we care for you. We actually reach out to you with our prayer, with our dua. And all those who are watching, I'm sure we'd all agree that we reach out to them minimum with our prayer. May Allah make it easy for you. May Allah help you, grant you goodness. May Allah alleviate your suffering. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala take away whatever is, you know, the barrier between you and happiness, between you and goodness. Those who are struggling in their homes, my brothers and sisters, come on, come on. You know, we always say enough is enough. Let's try and have the best possible homes, the best relationships. Try and prove yourself just to your family, and that is the beginning. But rather than trying to prove yourself to everyone else in a fake way, and your family is suffering and struggling because of the temperament you have, the anger issues, whatever else. So we need to make, inshallah, a difference there. So may Allah grant us all a good death, and may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala also take us away when we've just engaged in obedience and not when we've engaged in sin. May Allah make the best of our days the last days, and the most noble and sacred of our deeds the last deeds. And that's a dua of the Prophet ﷺ. Allahumma ja'al khayra ayyamina awakhiraha wa khayra a'malina khawatimaha. Oh Allah, make the best of our days the last days, and make the best of our deeds the ending deeds, you know, the last deeds that we do. So we ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to let that happen for us. May the happiest day for every one of us be the day when we actually meet with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. I want to repeat one note before I actually end for today, and that is, when we have heard of people passing away, when we've heard of young and old and so on, you know, passing away, dying, whatever else it is, we need to have conviction within ourselves. Mu'mineen, they will be going to Jannatul Firdaus, to paradise. They're in a far better place than this world, which is filled with oppressive people and oppression and wrongdoers, to the degree that we all sometimes feel helpless when it comes to justice, when it comes to goodness, at times. We all feel feel helpless because we desperately would like to see solution to a lot of what's happening. But unfortunately, it's not as easy as it is said. Rather, it's a lot of hard work and effort, and the Almighty is in ultimate control. But don't blame the Almighty. A lot of it is to do with the way we've operated. When Allah gave us this earth, He gave it to us in a beautiful way. But Allah says, ظَهَرَ الْفَسَادُ فِي الْبَرِّ وَالْبَحْرِ بِمَا كَسَبَتْ أَيْدِ النَّاسِ. That, you know, corruption has actually overtaken and it has become rampant and apparent on earth, meaning at land and at sea. On land and at sea. Because of what the people have done. Because of what their hands have done. So remember that. It's us to blame. If there is chaos, corruption, don't blame Allah. Blame us. The fact that it was predestined and the fact that Allah knows does not justify us blaming Allah for something that we are guilty of. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala make it easy for every one of us and grant ease to all those who are struggling and suffering. I think of so many different people, and alhamdulillah, I thank Allah for the amount of times He has helped me and used me to reach out to people in so many different ways. And I don't need to advertise it. I don't need to make a noise about it. I don't need to speak up about things I've done. You know, there are different ways of dealing with issues. If you feel you'd want to deal with it by making a big noise online, you may do so. That may not be what everyone thinks. And it's not revelation to say you've got to make a big noise about things, because sometimes even the Quran says that وَلَوْ رَدُّوهُ إِلَى الرَّسُولِ وَإِلَى أُولِي الْأَمْرِ مِنْهُمْ لَعَلِمَهُ الَّذِينَ يَسْتَنْبِطُونَهُ مِنْهُمْ. You know, that sometimes when there is an issue or news of fear or news of, happiness, security, etc., important news, some people prefer to just broadcast it, make a big hoo-ha about it, you know. And the others, those who dealt with it in the correct way may have dealt with it differently. To try and get how to, perhaps plan the next step, that you would need to go back to what Allah and His Rasul have said, and you'd have to discuss it with people of sound knowledge in order to know. So there are different ways of dealing with things. Let's not think that the way I deal with things is the only way. And let's not think the way I think that others should deal with it is the only way. But let's appreciate one another. Everyone needs to undertake that we all will do whatever we believe we can do and we should do. And we will let others do whatever they believe they can do and they should do, for as long as every one of us is doing something about whatever negatives are happening. By the will of Allah, we're heading in the right direction, and we all love one another. We're all part of one ummah, the ummah of La ilaha illallah Muhammadur Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam, and that is the slogan that we have. May Allah bless you all. Jazakumullah khair. Thank you so much for listening. Inshallah, I put this up on YouTube shortly, and you may go to my YouTube channel, Mufti Menk. You can actually subscribe on that, and you can put it on alert. Prioritize it so that you can get alerted every day or second day I put up a video on my YouTube channel, and I've allowed others to actually also put up these videos from my channel, to take them from my channel, on condition that they give it the same title. They can actually post it on their own channels as well. So thank you so much, my brothers and sisters. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.